Well, hello there everyone and welcome to this video. Today I've got something nice for you guys, and it is a procedural braid generator that you can just draw. Alright, you can draw the shape of your braids and it will turn it into a braid. No matter how big, no matter how small, no matter the scale of your object, it will draw it nicely and attach it nicely to your object as well, like an actual hair braid will do. Right, so I think that's going to be a lot of fun for you guys. And there's one more benefit. There is two styles to it. You've got one that's basically the animation, anime styled one that is just styled with textures and with, yeah, materials. And we've got one of actual realistic looking hair. And you can switch between those with one simple checkbox, right? You can click it and it will turn it into realistic hair. Untick it and it will turn it back into your animation looking one, right? So that's going to depend on what you're looking for, the kind of style you have in your scene. But no matter the style, it will attach and make it perfect for your skill, for your object. And there's a lot of settings you can tweak as well. So have a look right here. Right, so I'm gonna start off in Blender by how you will start off as well. So let's say this is your own file, okay? Your own Blender scene, and you want to get the braid into your own scene. Easiest way to do this is just go to File, Append, locate the file you downloaded from me, go to Objects, and just select the braid object, the curve. And that will basically be this object. It will have the geometry nodes already in there, right? It will already be selected on that object. It will already be applied. And we also have the materials that will come with it. So by just appending that braid, you will have everything you need. Now, to start adding braids to your system, it is nice to first of all go to your modifier properties and just change the attachment object to what you want it to attach to, right? I can imagine you want it to be a head, the scalp of your object, for example. So we can just select this, the eyedropper, select the object you want it to attach to. And now just go to tab into curve, curve edit mode, I guess. And then we can go to the draw tool and just draw out our curve, right? However we want it to be, we can just draw it out, looking all nice and stuff, make a nice spiral there. And you can see that the actual modifiers, right, the settings, they will all change a little bit as well, depending on the length of this braid, right? So it doesn't matter how big your object is, it's going to work perfectly, right? For example, I have a big braid. I have a very big object, I need a big braid. Perfect, looking very nice. Or we have a small object. I can zoom in, draw a very small one. It's still going to be a nice looking braid, right? And that is just perfect. So it doesn't matter what skill you're working on, it will always look nice. All right, now what the attachment object does is basically attach the braids to your object. So I can move this around and your braids will stay attached to that object very nicely. I can scale this. It will stay nicely attached to that surface, right? Very nice. All right, next up, I got some other settings to show you. For example, we've got the attachment object, the scale of it, right? Which is basically the scale of this object, and it's being rescaled to attach itself to it. If I set this back to 1, right, which is going to be the original size, it's going to hover a little bit over the surface, which means that I just decrease the scale of that object a little bit before attaching it. Beautiful. And that also means that if you have a smaller braid, for example, right there, we may just have to tweak the attachment scale a little bit again, right? To be, for example, bigger. And you can also see that for some reason in smaller braids, very small braids, this little hair tie may look a little bit odd, which means you can just, you can just tweak the position or you can just manually edit. I don't think that's a very big problem. All right. So let's delete all of those curves. There we go. Just going to draw that back in there. That's actually a very nice looking one. Gonna decrease that scale a little bit. And then we've got some other options as well. All right. The braid overall thickness. We can tweak this setting to have the entire braid thickness tweaked as well. So I can make everything thinner. The entire braids are going to get thinner. And everything works very nicely together. Right. It's all going to depend on that value. I can make it thicker as well. It's all going to work very, very procedurally, very nicely. Right, next one, the braid strand thickness. Very easy. It's basically the thickness of each strand of those braids, right? You can make them very thin, very thick. Depends on what you're looking for. We've got the braid resolution. You don't have to play around with that a lot unless you're going to make a very, very, let's say, braid with high frequency, right? If I increase the frequency there, at some point, the actual resolution is not going to be high enough anymore to really follow up with the frequency, in which case you may just need to increase the resolution of the braid as well. Okay, now we've got the start point skill, which is something I really wanted to be added here. And you can see what it means, right? If a skill is up, it's basically going to move those starting positions to a more random location on the head, further away from the actual center of the braids, right? Which means that it looks like those starting positions, those starting hair positions, are going to be actually moving together into that braid, right? If you know what I mean. So I had this at like 3. We can also just decrease this, and that means that they're actually going to be closer together. Now make sure that it's not going to get too close, because if I do actually scale this all the way down, you can see that the cursor are actually going to be intertwining more together, in which case we just need to tweak some of the other settings as well. For example, the width and the depth of the braids, select both of them and just make them a little bit bigger. That means they're just going to be moving them out a little bit more. Alright, so just make sure to tweak those values according to your own liking. Beautiful. Now we've also got the starting position of the braids. We can tweak this to be closer at the starting points, or just reduce this all the way to make it more chaotic as a starting point. Okay. Overall rotation will basically rotate your entire braid. All right. It will rotate it around the axis. So basically tilt your braid. Just depends on your own preference, I guess, your own customization. And the frequency already showed this, so we can also just decrease that and we will have a lower frequency braid. And we can just tweak the width and depth settings. The width is basically the width of the braids, right? And the depth is going to be the depth there. You can see if I increase that, it's going to be more depth in the braid. Same for width, I can just increase that and it's going to be wider pretty much, okay? Now we've got the hairband object. You can create your own hairband. I just have one that I work with, and it is there. Right, so yeah, you can just use that hair tie object or use your own. We've got the hairband skill. I added the settings for that object in case you need to tweak the location, the rotation, or the skill a little bit. Can always happen, of course. And then we've got the fun setting, which turns your anime looking hair, right? It is now still quite animation looking. We've got the material, of course, but we can also turn this into a realistic looking hair braid, all right? So we can just check that little box and it will turn your hairs into actual looking hairs, right? You can see it right here. We got some very nice looking hair strands that follow the exact same settings, right? They are exactly the same shape as our other braid, which is something you may be able to use for your realistic renders as well. Beautiful. Now one more setting that I actually added there, and we of course have the realistic hair amount. You can decrease or increase that depending on how many hairs you actually need for the braid. Let's go with 100, let's go with 1000 as well, just to show you the different settings. And then we've got the actual hair thickness as well, right? In case you want thicker hair or thinner hair, you can tweak that to your own liking as well, all right? And then we have the starting noise strength, which is something I added because I wanted to really make it look like those hairs come from different spots on your scalp, for example. Which means that we add some noise starting strength, and if you want them to be all lined up in the center of the braid, you can just set this back to 0. It's probably going to take a second because I added 1000 hairs, and you will be able to see that they are now just connected at the same spot, which just looks a little bit more unrealistic to me, which is why I added some of that noise strength at the start. Beautiful, right? Those are all the settings. Now, one thing you may need to take into account, and I will show you that in the anime one, is that we have an output attribute as well, which is our UV, right? If that somehow gets disconnected, if that is no longer entered there, you can see that the hair is now just one solid color because it has no real UVs anymore to provide to the shaders, right, to the materials. So just make sure that this says our UV. There we go. Make sure that it always says that. Beautiful. Now let's check out some of the shaders and what we can change there. It's not very advanced for the hair. And it's really just a principled hair. BSDF, we can change the colors of the actual hair there. Let me show you. If you want to see it, I can just show you right here. Let's set this to 250. Make this realistic. There we go. It's as easy as that. And now we can just tweak those colors to, well, white, black. This is based on melanin. We can also set it to direct coloring if you want a blue braid for some reason. You can make it happen very, very easily. All right. Amazing. Now let's move on to the other material, which is the anime one. All right. We can just turn this to the anime styled one. Go to the materials, and it is all based on a few different materials there as well. A few different sliders, a few different color inputs. For example, we can change the entire hue of this braids. We have to do it twice. We have a mix of two shaders. We have a color ramp there. And we also have a group right here of anime hair. And you can change the hue on that as well. The brightness, the contrast. It all depends on what you are really looking for, but I think you get how to change that with the color ramp and the actual hue saturation, or you can just open this one and change the settings there. I don't think it's going to be that hard for you, right? So that is pretty much how you use this setup, right? Feel free to use it for whatever. I would love to see it back in your own models. I showed you that it doesn't matter the skill you're working on, it's going to work quite nicely. Now, if you're going to work very, very small, then the braids, the actual hair object, the hair tie object, it's going to move away for some reason. It moves away from the braids. But in that case, just go to your modifier panel and just get rid of that hairband object and just get the actual object on the right spot, I guess. Then we have the one small issue. If you use smaller braids as well, you may just have to increase the attachment object skill a little bit so it is closer to the actual outer parts of your mesh, right? That's also why I added that, because for smaller objects you need this object to be closer to one, the value closer to one, and for bigger braids you may need them, you can see it right there, you can set them closer to the actual center, which means the skill is going to be lower. Right, that's pretty much all you need to know. And that's all there is to it as well. Just go ahead and start adding your beautiful looking braids. I can even write a little heart for you guys because you watch my channel, because you like, you subscribe. If you like this, please go ahead and sub. There we go, it's all going to get attached to the sphere. And like if you want, of course. And leave a comment. I always love reading those. And I take your suggestions quite heavy as well. I love doing suggestions. And then I'll see you in the next one. Many thanks and have a great, great day. Bye.